You are listening to the Spiritual Logic Channel on 91.5 WDBK. And I'm your host, Silver. And today, last week, we talked about does being more spiritual make you more happy, as opposed to does being less spiritual make you more happy? And today, this week, we're going to be talking about the importance of faith. The importance of faith. And I'm here with a friend of mine, Michael. I'm here with a friend of mine, Michael. And he's gonna also share his opinions on the importance of faith. So you all listen today, and hopefully you're gonna learn something that would help improve your life. Thank you. So do you want to go first, Mike?
Sure. Thanks for having me, Silver. Regarding faith and its importance alone, we naturally use it as a system of belief, which is totally fine. I mean, those who do feel as though that they have to label faith kind of feel that comfort within having it, you know?
Okay.
But it doesn't really mean that you have to label it under any sort of category, such as a religion, or even in most cases just a life source in and of itself, but rather just a lifestyle, if it be in such ways to whoever has that kind of faith. And then of course are people who do not have faith at all, which by their own standards and by their own preference is totally fine. But then of course, without having it, what is it that you do have to continue on within a life of spirituality?
Okay. Michael, people might say that faith is a very abstract concept, that they cannot put their belief, because faith is you believing something that you cannot see, like having faith in the future, having faith that everything is going to be okay, believing that everything is going to be okay. You don't know that everything is going to be okay, so why should we have this faith? Why should we have this hope, this belief that everything is going to be okay? Does it actually work for us? Does faith actually work for us in our everyday life? Like, what do you think?
Well, faith isn't really a subject which gives certainty, but rather something to which we see and use as our basis in a way of saying that we may not know that it's going to be okay or not, but in understanding that it will work out itself, we have faith that in the process that we will be okay during and after that process. For instance.
So wouldn't you say it's still a blind? It's like you're walking into a dark room without knowing, there's no light in there. You don't know what the things that you might trip on stuff, you might fall. So should you walk in that dark room anyways? It's like being blindfolded, basically. You know, should you still have this belief that you're gonna be okay? What if there are nails on the floor?
Well, in a real-time sense, or at least in a sense with that analogy, that's still within the importance of having faith anyway. Because whether you are in that dark room and you're stepping on nails, you're getting bumped into walls, you're hitting roadblocks, it's faith in which helps you seek whatever it is that you're trying to find even within that dark room. So in other words, despite the trials to which you must undergo with having faith, it is still by that faith that keeps you searching and eventually find what you are looking for. It is not really much of a matter of going into the void and darkness, but rather going into it, seeking something, achieving it, despite the time it takes to receive it.
That's very interesting. That's very interesting. So you're saying that, what you're saying is that just by believing in what you're after and what you're looking for and what you're seeking, it doesn't matter if you're in a void or if you're in a dark room or even in a black hole, no matter what it is, you're going to find what you're looking for anyways.
Well, of course.
With your belief.
Indeed. It's just an understanding that how can one have faith without the works to achieve what it is that they are designed or their desires are? Does one have faith in nothing and then achieve nothing in return? Or can one have faith into something to know that that something will be achieved despite how hard they work, or despite how much time it takes to receive it? To have faith in something is to have faith that that something will come to pass, despite all odds.
Interesting. That's very interesting. I actually know the benefit of faith. I know the importance of faith. I know what faith is, but I guess I'll just play the devil's advocate. So we can, so the those that are listening out there can understand what faith actually is. And he's right. Like you said, faith, basically to me, everything is faith because everything is spiritual. So faith to me is that what you hold within your heart, whatever belief, whatever concept you hold within your heart space, you hold within your mind, becomes what you find, becomes what surrounds you, becomes your environment, becomes your reality, becomes your experience. So, like you said, if you are seeking for nothing, you would find nothing, because that's the faith you hold within yourself. You hold a faith that you're not looking, you know, there's nothing, so you would find nothing. But if you hold a faith of something and you're seeking for something, you would find something. It's like the law of attraction, basically.
Yes.
You know, very similar to the law of attraction. Faith, you know, faith holds the bounds of everything. Do you have anything you want to say about that?
Well, you basically covered it. Yes.
Yeah.
It's just we often discourage ourselves with what faith actually is, only because we see it as, well, I tried my best, why hasn't this come to pass?
Right.
Instead of thinking, I tried my best, how much do I have to do in order for it to come to pass? See what I mean? It's all natural. It is a natural way of thinking, because it is a humanistic way of thinking as well. It's just taking understanding of what we think we know and then broadening it to ask more questions than what we think is the answer to other questions. But really, the answers to which we may try to seek are actually just, in a sense, bases of other questions. If we were to find an answer to one thing, how are we able to find that answer? And is there anything else in which we need to find in order to continue on within the process of our own lifestyle? It's why in taking faith, in this case, is vitally important for those who do have faith to look at it in a way to where it's not in any way a respecter of those who try to achieve, but those who continue so that they can achieve.
Okay. So what would you say? What would you say are the importance of faith? What would you say to someone that doesn't know the importance of faith? Doesn't even know the concept of faith? Because to me, we are created with these attributes, and we use these attributes in our everyday life without actually knowing it. You know, in your education, you know how they say faith without work
is dead?
Is meaningless.
Indeed.
Is dead. Yes.
Yes.
So like in your education, like you have to actually study for you to get that A. So, but you do have that faith, that you would get that A. But is it because you studied? Or is faith actually a blind concept? Or is faith actually something that it's mathematically can be calculated?
See, now that's the thing. That actually leads me back to what I said before, to where it's nothing that you can label as maybe a religion to some, or just something to just obtain. Even those who say that they are faithless have faith by what they do in the lives in which they live. Only because for those who are religious or in their way spiritual, who do look into scripture, I'm one of faith myself who look into scripture, not only would it be a viable scripture to say that faith without works is dead, but by defining faith being the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And sometimes the evidence of things not seen doesn't correlate with spirituality in a sense, although that is what it touches most of the time. But can we not define the future to be something that we cannot see quite yet, only because we are created or born to live in the now? To have faith into what is to come is to also understand that the effort it takes to take what is to come only is respecting of the effort it must undergo in its own lifestyle, if you understand what I mean in that regard. So to say that one who does have faith to continue on in that faith but still cannot see the efforts, it is by due diligence of their efforts on getting what they have. What you put in is what you take out, in a sense. So whatever you are putting in within whatever you're trying to achieve can only give back what you give it, because it is what it is used to work with. You know, like all the other efforts necessary to get you to the point to where you want to be, you first have to give in all that is necessary in order to reach that point.
Something that you said reminded me of where the true meaning of faith was. I've seen and come across the Bible a lot, which is the evidence of something not seen. So the evidence of something not seen, does that mean that thing is still not there? Like, for example, you want to get that A. You want to excel in your studies. This is something that you haven't reached yet, you haven't acquired yet, but you have faith that you're gonna that you can do it.
Yes.
So the evidence of something not seen yet, that's abstract. I know the answer to this, but I want you to clarify on that before I actually go into my own point of view. The evidence of something not seen, so that is called faith. But is that something that we should like practice in our everyday life?
Most certainly. Yeah. It's just, and that's another thing too. It's part of what faith is, with the other part being the substance of things hoped for. And even if you were to digest that and to actually try to take that in its entirety, you still need that other half, to which we just mentioned, which was the evidence of things not seen. Now, going back to that dark room that we were talking about, you know, you don't know what you're going to be stepping on, you don't know what you're going to be running into. You going into this dark room and continuing forward within that dark room being faith, sometimes you can have faith of something being there in your way. It's a double-edged sword in this case, to where the evidence of things not seen, you can go in that dark room and not see that nail on the floor, but as soon as you take that first step, you'll believe, you know, kind of thing, and it's going to be there, and it's going to hurt a lot, but you keep going, because that nail isn't what you're looking for.
Okay. I'm gonna explain to you guys my understanding as well of what faith is and why it's very, very important that we have faith and that we practice faith in our everyday life, because we do it anyways. We do. You would agree that we do this. We have faith. We practice faith every day.
Yeah.
Everybody does it.
Mm-hmm.
Even the animals does it.
Yeah.
Every living creature does it, but they don't actually think of it as faith. They don't actually put it in that perspective that, oh, I'm having faith.
Right.
You know? But what I'm trying to say here is faith, to me, in my understanding, remember we were having a discussion the other day on Monday about free will?
Yes.
And how free will correlates basically to God. How
mm-hmm.
God gave us the same thing that he has,
mm-hmm.
which is free will. And if God gave us free will, which dictates our choices, which dictates we can choose our choices, our actions in every moment, in every minute, in every second, without some outside force manipulating our will. So faith, to me, that is the concept of faith itself. Faith is your free will. Free will and faith are intertwined together in a way that your free will affects your future. Your free will affects your past. Your free will affects your now moment. Meaning to say that if your free will are affecting all these things, isn't that, that's still basically the same thing as faith. That is who we are. We are created through faith. So, meaning to say that our faith in our free will, our faith in our future, we should always have faith in our creations. We should always have faith in creating something that we want. You know, like if you want to get that A, or you want to get that luxurious car, or you want to get that good job or that house, your free will and your faith intertwine together in a way that they would create that future, that possibility for you, that outcome for you. As long as you believe and you walk towards that belief, that is your literally creating, co-creating as God along with your faith. It's the reason why the Bible says without faith it is impossible for you to please God, right?
Indeed.
Because for you to please God is for you to walk with God.
Yes.
And that's what God wants for us to co-create with him. Literally everything we do is creation, right? Just by breathing, by talking, by communicating, this conversation we're having right now is creation. And creation is through our free will of expression, of how we want to express ourselves, how we want to express our soul, how we want to express our divine rights, basically. So then, why is it important that we have faith? It is important to me, it is very important that we have faith, because it is vitally merged with our free will, in a sense that it is affecting every moment to moment of our life. So if you're not having faith, if you're not having faith in the things that you want to see, in the things that you want to experience, all the good things you want to experience, you're not giving up. You're not saying it's not possible, or it's not possible. The economy cannot support this, or the government cannot support this, I'm talking about for people like in third world countries where the government just pretty much cannot help them out, and they give up financially, they pretty much just settle for less. Faith can get you to wherever you want to go. As long as you have faith and you're walking with that faith, it is affecting your free will. and it is pulling your free will towards the experience of that faith that you've created in your heart, that image you've created in your heart, in your mind. So whatever faith that you, whatever faith you have within yourself, whatever belief you hold within yourself, you create it through faith. So to me, faith is not an abstract concept. It's not, people, I've heard people say, but faith is just blindly, you're blindly following God. You're blindly following God. How can you blindly follow something? You don't know where you're going. That's where I differ. That's why I say, no, you're not, you're creating with God. So you're telling God what you want to experience. It's the reason why God put you on this planet. Would you agree, right?
Quite so. As a matter of fact, that reminds me of a joke I heard some time ago. There was a man in the jungle who was trying to hunt for a lion. And as he found the lion saw him before he saw the lion. So he ran and he prayed. He said, Lord Father, please save me from this lion, for I am a Christian, a sinless Christian who follows all your commandments. And the lion stopped. But then he heard mumbling coming from the lion. And so he came closer, and the mumbling started to get louder until he actually got to the point to where the, he heard the lion praying, oh, thank you, Lord, for this meal, you know, kind of thing. So in understanding that faith, be it misconstrued as a essence necessary to have religion, it's not a, a concept to where you take it and define your religion as, but rather a concept to take to define your life as. By taking the practice of religion in your life and you separate them as two entities in a sense. By applying faith into how you live only constitutes how you live your life. But it does not in any way constitute as the religion to where one may misconstrue it to be, as each and every religion still regards that faith factor. All of the books of the Bible make up one message. So if even every book of that same book make up that one message being faith, then how many other things in the life that we live today do the very same thing? See what I mean? It's not taking faith and converting it into a religion, but taking faith unadulterated at its essence, in using that as your way of life, your way of living.
So basically, using faith as your tool for creation.
Indeed. Exactly from what you're expressing as well.
Yeah.
As such, is still in correlation to how we are supposed to live our lives, or at least how we live our lives on our
which is why I'm going back to the concept that we are created through faith. And we apply faith in our everyday life without actually realizing it. So, but then when we do realize that we're using faith to create our experience, we start to have faith in the much positive things,
yes,
the much positive experiences rather than the negative experiences, because faith will bring to you, including the negative experience that you hold within your heart space.
Yes.
So it's the reason why faith is very important to getting rid of fear, anxiety, all the negative attributes, panic, all the things that you don't need, all the things that would set you below standard, below the person that, the image of the person that you want to be. So it's very important that we have faith. It's very, not so that it's very important that we have faith, but it's very important that we have faith in the positive things.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah, this is very interesting. Right. Very interesting, because I don't normally think about this, but when I tested you earlier,
yeah,
that you inspired me to talk about this topic, because after we left last Monday night, I just kept thinking about it, and I'm like, faith, you kept talking about it. Yeah, I'm like, yeah. faith, and you got it stuck in my head. And then I started to think about it, and I'm like, I'm using faith in my everyday life. I'm implementing faith in my everyday life. I'm a very spiritual person. So when I say spiritual, I mean like I believe that everything is intertwined, is integrated and connected. And it can be controlled and manipulated with my thoughts, with the way I think, with my perspective, and with the way I see the world around me. So when I start to use faith in a positive way, I started to see and understand the laws of spirituality even more. I started to realize that everything is spiritual, everything is connected, because everything was manifesting for me, like through the law of attraction. Everything that I was thinking and everything I wanted to experience was just being manifested to me, like the way I met you. I pretty much wanted, when I started doing this show on the radio, I pretty much was thinking about having people, just having a discussion with people that understand the topics. So that I wouldn't, because I knew that I can teach these topics very easily, but I knew it would be even better if I can have different perspective, different mindset on the subject. It would help people that are listening to get different backgrounds. It will help them to fully understand. And so I was trying to look for people, like-minded people like myself, which was when I had met Joe longer before then, but I didn't know he would want to be on my show. And I was so happy that he came on my show and that he agreed to want to be on my show. And from there, he introduced me to you, and which is, I started to understand that the way I think, the perspective I hold about life was important, and which is, was very, very important in shaping the world around me, and which is faith through surrender, which is something else I want to talk about. You know, I was going to talk about this towards the end of the this show, but I'm gonna bring it up early anyways. Faith through faith causes surrender. Would you agree? It creates a sense of surrender where you're not trying to control everything around you.
Yes.
Rather, you are giving control to what you say. How did you say it again in the Bible, that faith is the belief in something,
the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Evidence not seen.
Right.
So when you're having faith in the evidence of things not seen, you're surrendering to the universe, to the energy of God, of the Spirit of God, that everything is going to be okay. And with that surrender, you know, you're attracting, that's your perspective now. And your perspective will draw to you what you attract, like the way I met you. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, the way I met Sean, the way I met, like, my perspective started to draw to me the things that I, what, do you have something you were saying?
Oh, no, it's okay. It's just that, like, I'm listening, and, of course, just how we did last night, just kind of add on to it, and then have,
right.
So, yeah, I'm right. Okay. Totally fine.
My perspective started to draw to me the people that, just by me not, by me literally not doing anything, just by just believing and having faith that, holding it within my heart space that I want to be around like-minded people that understand my spiritual lifestyle, that understand the importance of spirituality and how to, and that is very important in our everyday life. And by having faith in that, I surrendered to the experience. I let go completely. And I was not, I did not try to control anything. I did not try to go out there. I mean, faith requires you to actually walk.
Yes.
Because without walk, without faith, without walk is meaningless.
Yes.
But it doesn't require, walk is different from control. It doesn't require the ego. It doesn't require to use the ego to try to control everything, to try to make everything be 100% correct without surrendering to the flow of God, of nature.
Right. As a matter of fact,
allow nature to take over.
Yes. Yeah. That's the thing too, because Thank you for reminding me. I actually wanted to mention something regarding that.
Okay.
Referring back to scripture.
Okay.
Or I'm pretty sure other people can agree once reading it. Where it says, show me a man who has faith by their works, and I'll show you a man who has faith with their works. Or excuse me, faith with their works, I'll show you a man with faith by their works. In other words, saying that to one...
Say that again?
To say, show me a man who has faith with their works, and I'll show you a man who has faith by their works.
Okay.
To have faith with your works is to have faith in the works, instead of having that work in which supports that faith. You can't just... It's expressing a sense of equivalent exchange.
Right.
Yes.
I understand that now. I like that. I like how you coined that. Equivalent exchange. That's very, very necessary. You guys grab that concept. Equivalent exchange. It's a perfect dance between you and God.
Yes.
Between God and man, or between God and nature, between man and nature, or between man and the universe, or whatever you want to call it. But this, we know that we are not 100% in control, right?
Right.
We do know that there's, like, whenever we make good choices, there is this whatever nature or this parental, parent-like force that rewards us with our good choices.
Mm-hmm.
But if we make bad choices, we are rewarded with the consequences of, like, you know, perhaps like going to jail or, you know, stuff like that.
And that's another thing too. Yeah, like, the actions you make in this life do not define who you are. It is whether or not your decision on making those mistakes become decisions in your life to where you are able to define yourself. Hence why having faith in things that are for you are specifically for you only. You can have faith in other things for other people, but you can't do what other people want to do for themselves. Only because that is a personal thing. It's a personal concept that is both, like, external and internal regarding the person who does have that faith, to where it may be shown but can only be shared on a basis to where everybody else understands it, but they have to acquire their own, because everybody's different with their own sorts of ambitions, with their own sorts of course, with their own source of decisions to make. Therefore, all that applies within their life must also be applied within the works to achieve what it is in the end of their work, to where they are able to look back on that faith and understand that that is what pulled them forward. Because without it, what else are you achieving?
Exactly. This is such a beautiful topic, you guys. I'm loving what he's saying right now, because it's like I'm having mind augers right now. You're literally reminding me of the importance. You just said something. You said it pulls you forward.
Yes.
Faith. You guys need to grab this concept. Faith is very important because it pulls you forward towards your destination. It pulls you forward towards your heart desire. It pulls you forward towards the things that you want to see.
Yes.
The more I started to practice faith, the more I started to understand that everything really was spiritual and everything was correlated. That we are literally co-creating with God, that God never left us. Who we call God, or the energies of God, or the spirit of God, never left us. Never left. We are co-creating with God, but we cannot please God. We cannot co-create with God if we don't have faith. Because, like you coined it, it is an equivalent exchange. It is between man and God. It is between you and your. It is why God searches the heart and not the mind. Because the mind holds different many beliefs, it holds different many perspectives, but the heart is simple. The heart knows what it wants, and it would have that faith that it can either do it or it cannot do it.
That's yes. So,
and if it has that faith, it cannot do it. It would not do it. Yeah. It is the reason why I make these videos, to elevate your spirits. I make this podcast to elevate your spirits, to know that you should have a much greater faith in yourself. Because how you see yourself, the faith that you put on yourself, is the faith that will come back to you.
Yes.
It is like you said, an equivalent exchange. God will give you whatever you give to yourself. So you have to have faith in a much broader, expansive, greater you that is capable of doing anything. Otherwise, you would be small forever and you would be a victim forever.
Yes.
So,
as a matter of fact, you actually bring a really good point, because I know there are other atheists out there, and that's totally fine. They believe whatever they desire.
That's the thing, though. You don't, being atheist or not being atheist, everybody has this spirituality within them.
Yeah.
It is who you are. You cannot escape it. You are in it. You are created by it and through it. It flows through your veins. So if you want to be an atheist or you want to be religionist, it doesn't matter what you are.
Exactly.
You cannot escape that you're created in the image of God, in the image of the spirituality that is impossible for you to even imagine, that how you even alive. You are alive through faith. You are alive, and it's spiritual. It is impossible.
Just because you don't believe it,
it's a miracle.
It's not there.
Yes, because you don't believe it doesn't mean it's not there. Exactly.
And understanding that what your point was regarding that, referring back to scripture, to where you said that that's why God searches the heart and not the mind.
Right.
Well, by taking that all together, what it's actually expressing from in the Bible is that, well, God searches the heart and not the mind, mm-hmm. and faith without works is dead. So, with understanding that, mm-hmm. with faith being the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen, mm-hmm. with also having faith without works being dead, then were a man's heart, or where a man's work his art, or where a man's work is his heart is also, which is also another scripture, also means that with God searching the heart, knowing that the works that come with that faith has no other choice but to come to pass by their works.
Exactly.
Four different scriptures scattered throughout the entire
exactly.
Bible come together.
Coming together in such a unique, you know, bringing it together,
yes.
to form a one, to give you a one clarified perspective that everything literally is faith, is based on your faith.
Yes.
You know? You cannot succeed without faith.
You can translate these kind of things. If somebody doesn't want to hear about God, you can still translate it in a way to where it's still true. Because it's not about whether or not you take the faith and you apply it, which is exactly why I say you can't label it with anything. It's not the fact that you take faith and you put it in a specific kind of religion, but it's an understanding that how you are supposed to live out your life, or how you live out your life, can always be the best in your own way. Be you better. Be you, but better. Because only you can be you better.
Be the better version of yourself.
Indeed.
Pretty much. Be the better version. How do you be the better version of yourself, you guys? Through faith. Through faith. It is how you be. You have faith. And because we are free will, our free will literally echoes through time and space. Meaning to say that your actions and your choices have already been, even though you have free will, your free will and your choices are infinite, meaning you can choose and do whatever you want. And because you can choose and do whatever you want, these things can be calculated. It can be calculated when you think about it, but it can be calculated in infinite amount of ways. Meaning to say that I can do it, I can do whatever I want right now. You can do whatever you want right now. You can just get up and leave. That's your free will. You're expressing your free will. Now, but who we call God, that gave us this free will to literally be able to live in the moment and make our decisions in the moment as gods, as small gods. Co-creating with him, he still also knows your, he knows your decisions, he knows your choices, he knows everything you're gonna do. He knows your, that you have this infinite choice. So he knows the infinite possibilities of things that you can do.
Yeah, and that's also regarding in the sense where people say, well, why does God allow suffering?
Well, God does not allow suffering as much as man allows suffering on themselves.
God allows choice.
Choice.
You allowed suffering.
Say that again, man.
God allows choice. You allow suffering.
God allows choice. You allowed suffering. I'm gonna quote that. I'm gonna quote you on that. When I edit this video, I'm gonna quote you on that. He said, God allows choice, and you allow
suffering.
This is such a deep. I love whenever they talk about spirituality, like things about God and nature. I love it so much because it's like I cannot. It's like it's. This is the most important education in life, because like this is your lifestyle. You're living your life like this, but people don't. They don't meditate enough to understand that spiritual laws are literally being applied in their life, in their everyday choices, and your free will, your faith, your everything that you do. Spirituality itself.
Yes, and to clarify that as well, not yours, but in my part,
okay.
There are other topics towards like, well, what if one didn't do anything to deserve the things in which they'd have underwent in their life? There are certain things that happen to, it's not a fact to why do bad things happen to good people, it's why do things happen to people, period. It's not in regards to having you done something that regards such a suffering, but rather, what does this event do to help you grow or become the person you're supposed to be? Without you knowing it, you can always become better. And that is what we always do, even subconsciously throughout our entire lives, we do it. But by taking our shortcomings in life, or taking the suffering that which we have to undergo in the life that we live, we tend to focus on why this happens instead of how can this, not why, but how can this be something for me instead of against me? What can I take from this? And sometimes it is not easy to do that. I can tell you firsthand. My father, one of the lessons to which he taught my sister and I before he passed was, give back what was given to you. And of course, we were in grade school at the time, but what he was expressing touches on universal topics, with faith being one of them, that even when something is given to you that is not for you, you can take it. Hold on to it, have it become something that is for you, and then give it back. This is how we give birth to inspiration. This is how we inspire an entire generation of people who undergo their own troubles and have no idea as to how they are able to take that trouble and convert it into something more. Because we can't go through things that we aren't able to handle. For such just cannot be done. That equivalent exchange concept applies to so many other things, whether it be the equivalent exchange of giving something to you, knowing that you are able to give it back in the same effectiveness, but in a different way. And this is also can be translated within Einstein's, or excuse me, it wasn't Einstein's, but who was the physicist that says, with every action is an
opposite reaction. Was it Isaac Newton?
I do believe, yes.
Yeah, equal and opposite reaction, yeah.
That in and of itself is that same equivalent exchange process. With equivalent exchange coming from the very dead science being alchemy.
Exactly.
But exactly. The concept itself isn't dead, it's just the understanding and the ideology that was used for it that does not work. But where it does work is within the personal aspects in our lives, to where we are able to take it and translate it into something that can be so much more for us, that we can actually look at the other person who's struggling and say, hey, it's not over. What is the only thing you want to hear in the life you have to live, other than just keep going and it will be fine? I like to reference Life of Pi. I'm pretty sure those who read the book.
The movie.
Yes. I heard of the book before, or at least I watched the movie before the book, but I never read the book.
Okay.
In the end of that movie, though, Pi expressed, now we have a saying in India, it'll all work out in the end. And if it doesn't, then it's not the end. So,
interesting.
When living the life you live today, instead of looking at it as, oh yeah, it is what it is, see it more so as a chance to make it more than what it is now.
Okay, guys. Just for the sake of our time, because this is so annoying. We have such a short time for this show, and these topics are so important, and I just want to go on and on forever about this. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have a part two on this topic.
Yeah.
But I want to bring something up to you about a story from the Bible. I'm pretty sure you're familiar with the story of Job. Because people that are listening out there, they might be saying, okay, well, what you're preaching towards is that pretty much so if I have faith, everything is going to be okay, and my life will just be bread and butter, and I have paradise, or heaven on earth. Yes, that's true. That is what I'm preaching to you, and that's what I want you to understand. Because everything is spiritual, meaning to say that your life is in God's hand. You just have to surrender to the experience, and that you can do that through faith. But in the story of Job, the devil came to God and said to God, Job has all of these things. Job has all of these good things. He has all these riches. He's blessed with family. He's blessed with loved ones, friends, respect. He's blessed with lands. He's blessed with riches, with everything. So, of course, he's going to remain faithful and loyal to you. And this is what the devil was saying to God, right? Of course, he's going to remain faithful and loyal to you. Why don't you take all of these things away? And even go as far as make his health, worsen his health, make him put him in a state where he was to the point that he was almost about to die. Why don't you take all of these things away from him and see if he will still have faith in you and be loyal to you? So what I'm saying right now, because I want to get your perspective real quick, but what I want to say to those of you that are listening out there is that having faith doesn't mean that it's going to be easy. You will be tested along the way. There'll be a lot of tribulations. There'll be people that will say to you, that thing you have faith in, that thing that you believe that you can do, that you can accomplish, you can't do it. You can't reach it. You can't succeed. But you can reach and be whoever you want. You can reach your goals. You can do whatever you want. But the devil, when the devil had God to test Job, and God took away all these things, I'm trying to say to people that are listening out there that you can also experience the same things that Job went through. Am I wrong?
Yes. No, you're not wrong.
So you can experience the same thing that Job went through. It's not gonna, having faith doesn't mean that it's gonna be completely easy for you.
Right.
But it gives you a destination. It gives you a hope for the future. It pulls you towards that future. It pulls you towards that destination. And so what do you have to say about the story of Job, like, and how faith and all?
Well, that's where I got the scripture, show me a man who has faith with the works, and I'll show you a man who has faith by the works.
Oh.
So, and that's the thing too. Like, it's never going to be easy.
Right.
It's never going to be easy.
It's never going to be easy.
But it doesn't automatically mean it's going to be hard. There's always an in-between regarding these things.
And if it's hard, if it feels hard to you, it's not that way. It's not going to be that way forever. It's just a test.
Yes, trials are trials.
Trials are trials.
You always express a trial to be, you know, if somebody goes into a free trial of something, it is but a taste on what it is before you actually go into it again. Look at your trials in life the same way, to where it is a taste of what will make you stronger or what will make you more.
Exactly. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Quite so.
It is the reason why the test comes along the way.
Yes.
To make you stronger for that thing that you desperately want to achieve. That thing that you desperately... It wants to see how much you truly need it. How much you truly want it. How much you desire those things.
And not all trials are bad either. Because there are trials in which come through that are just great. But that doesn't mean that everything that feels good is good for you.
Right. That's true.
Now, and it doesn't mean that everything that does not feel good is bad for you either.
Yes.
There's another side to that. And even with understanding that faith, be it the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen, having it will help you achieve that very same success. And as I said once before, multiple times back in my early years, success is not a respecter of ethnicity, of race, of age, or anything regarding that. Success is a respecter of those who desire to achieve it.
Say that again, please.
Success is a respecter of those who try and desire to achieve it.
So success is a respecter of those
who try and desire to achieve it.
Who try hard enough and desire to achieve it. Did you get that from somewhere? Is that yours?
This is all personal experience.
That's very interesting. I'll quote you on that.
Yeah. How many things are going to go with me today?
Yeah, it's very interesting. Very, very, very interesting stuff that we're talking about here today. I wish we had more time.
I do,
but,
too.
Yeah, but we only have like 1 minute here left. So I'm going to wrap up the main point of what we're saying in these videos and in this podcast. Basically, those of you that are listening out there here on 91.5 WDVK, faith is very, very important. Without faith, you cannot succeed. You cannot succeed. But believe it or not, I'm not telling you to be religious. This is not a religion. I'm not preaching to you to be a Christian or a Muslim or whatever. I'm just telling you to have faith. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in the things that you want to see, in the things that you want to accomplish. Have faith in the world. Have faith in everything around you. Have faith in people. Even when people are making the wrong choices, even when you see them clearly making the wrong choices, still have faith in them. It's all part of the game. It's free will. It's all part of life. It's a dance of free will. Like he said, like my friend Michael just said over here, it's a equivalent exchange between God and man, between what you cannot see, the abstract which you cannot see, which is spiritual, which is before our very eyes, but we cannot see it. When you have faith in it, it has faith in you, and it pulls you forward towards your goal. And when there are things that are gonna try to make it harder for you, don't give up. Don't think, oh, well, you know, I tried. Don't give up. If you give up, don't give up. I cannot tell you what will happen if you give up, but do not give up. Because having faith is the miracle itself. It is the magic. That's why Jesus kept teaching about that. Remember what he said, "Oh, you man of little faith," when he said to Peter?
Yes.
He was so disappointed. He was so disappointed because he had been with the disciples for so long that they should have picked up this, you know, God-like essence from him. And the way he performed his miracles, the way he did everything that he did, it was just sheer willpower through faith alone. And faith alone, he was able to accomplish and bend space and time and walk on waters and heal and raise the dead and do whatever he did just by having faith alone. And he was so upset. He was like, "You man of little faith." And Peter was thinking, it was like, "Lord, please save me." Have faith. Without faith, it is impossible for you to succeed. I keep repeating that. Because succession is the reason why we are all born. for us to succeed in whatever endeavors and whatever things we're striving for. In whatever things that we want to accomplish, success is the reason why we are born. And if you cannot, you cannot succeed if you don't have faith in yourself. So have faith in the things that you are. Have faith in yourself is very important. You have anything to say, Mike?
You pretty much covered it. It's just an understanding that this be a topic greater than what we may perceive within just a human intellect.
But yes,
still able to take it for what it is, because we are a lot more than what we think we are.
Yes, thank you. So we are a lot more than, we are more than just the brain. We are not the brain. We are more than the brain. The brain is just to capture just a fraction of consciousness within the physical vessel so that we can experience life in a subjective manner. But then the part of us that we cannot see, the abstract part of us that is so much bigger than just the brain and the body alone, is that thing that we need to believe in. We need to have faith in that thing. It's not a blind faith. It's not something stupid or ridiculous. It's going to get you to your goals. It's going to get you to your destination. Don't give up.
And just to throw that out there, having faith isn't always easy either.
Yes, it's not.
And there are those who say, well, I don't need faith. And that's totally fine. Though those who say that may not recognize that they do have it, but yet they still live out their lives understanding that they don't. That isn't to down-talk those kind of people, but rather to express to them, saying that whether you feel as if you don't need it or not, here you are, still standing where you stand.
Exactly. They're doing it. They're having faith without realizing it. So when people say things like that, like I'm an atheist, or I feel like that's ignorant. That's just plain ignorant, because we do it. It's who we are. It's in our nature. We do these things without actually... When they actually think about it, they realize in so many ways in their days, in every day of their life, they are actually implementing faith. They implement, even in their breathing.
Yes.
Why don't they just stop breathing then? Because they have faith that they will keep breathing. Why don't they not wake up in the morning? Because they have faith. Why aren't they afraid to go to bed, to go to sleep at night?
Yeah.
That they wouldn't wake up in the morning. And they call themselves atheists. It doesn't matter what you are.
Atheism.
You know that you have faith that you're going to wake up in the morning.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yes.
So you're not afraid to go to bed in the morning. You don't see anybody, I'm scared to sleep because I may not wake up. Everybody has faith. Everybody, even animals have faith.
Yeah.
They implement this faith. They practice it.
Yeah.
But it's just we're not fully conscious of it. When we're fully conscious of these things, we begin to practice it even more. We begin to understand that everything is spiritual. We are in a spiritual, physical universe, and we're being taken care of, we're being monitored, we're being taken care of. God is in everything, and God is loving everything. He just wants to experience life. God is eternal. He just wants to experience life, and he just wants to, So what do you have anything you want to say?
I was just going to say, atheism is, in a sense, still faith.
Yeah.
And everything is right. We don't really know when our life is going to just come to an abrupt end. Like each second is not promised.
Right, that's true.
But it is not only with us being used to each second that we live, but just an understanding that very same faith keeps us saying that this next second is going to be when I still breathe.
Exactly. We're having faith in every moment. We're having faith in every second. We're having faith in each and every experiences that we have.
Yes.
We're always having faith. We're always practicing these things without realizing it.
Yeah.
So, anyway, we are way out of time.
Yeah.
Anyway, until next time, until next week, you guys. Love you all. Bye-bye. This is the Spiritual Logic Channel on 91.5 WDBK. And as usual, I'm your host, Silver. You can look me up on Instagram at Lord Silver of Heaven. I like to believe that the Spirit of the Lord is within me. And we are all in the presence of God in heaven, whether we realize it or not. and look me up on my YouTube channel, The Spiritual Logic. If you want to subscribe and follow and get more of our weekly videos, I really appreciate that. Have a good day and bye bye.
This is Laura. You're listening to 91.5 WDBK, Camden County College, Gloucester Township, New Jersey.
You're listening to 91.5 WDBK, Camden County College, Blackwood, New Jersey.
Welcome back to the Cat Show. Up next, we have Nico. Nico is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right. A group known especially for their sunspot sleeping, ball chasing, leg rubbing, and of course, companionship. Just look how she struts.
It's like she owns the place.
And see how she curls up and cuddles her person.
The pitch on her purring is simply perfect.
Nice one.
Fantastic cat. But really the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Nico is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Hi, this is Tamsin from Wilson, and you're listening to 91.5 WDBK.
Hello, my name is Christina.
Hello, my name...
Just have it for me